Hello, I'm Bill Mercer. Join me this week on World Class Championship Wrestling as we visit Chick Donovan in the hospital where he's recuperating from the injuries suffered at the hands of the Oriental Assassin, Killer Khan. Also this week, the modern-day warrior, Kerry Von Erich, squares off against that notorious headbanger, The Missing Link. Watch all the action this week on the world's greatest wrestling show, World Class Championship Wrestling. Welcome to World Class Championship Wrestling from the world-famed Sportatorium in downtown Dallas, Texas. And we've got a spectacular card for you, a spectacular main event. And that main event features the former World Heavyweight Champion, the modern-day warrior, Kerry Von Erich, against the strange man from somewhere who is missing, the missing link. And that is our main event, that missing link and Kerry Von Erich. Plus, we've got Iceman King Parsons and Gino Hernandez battling. And next, coming up on World Class Championship Wrestling, a casualty report of Killer Khan. That's right now, after this message on World Class Championship Wrestling. World-class Championship Wrestling's Killer Khan Casualty Report. As you know, Killer Khan has inflicted much pain and injury to Kevin Von Erich and Chick Donovan.
Kevin, in the vice grip, caught him by his father, Fritz Von Erich. He holds on to Killer Khan, who flails and fights and tries to get up. Putting a thumb in the eye of Kevin Von Erich. And Kevin ripped away by Killer Khan. But Khan now getting the reaction of that vice grip on his head. Looks like he might have a headache. And he goes in with a pure chokehold on Kevin Von Erich. Killer Khan, appropriately named. And he won't come off of Kevin Von Erich. And Khan now will just be eliminated right there, or should be, as he tosses David Manning by. Kevin ripping Khan. Kevin slamming Killer Khan. And now the claw again as David Manning tries to recover from his experience. Kevin with a claw hold, the iron claw on Killer Khan. Khan now working with the Oriental Spike in this corner. Jabs it into Kevin. The Oriental Spike into the neck of Kevin Von Erich. David Manning shaken, groggy. Still not in total control as they fight over the top rope. The claw on the Khan and the spike in Kevin, and here comes Bronco Lovich. And Bronco Lovich has got to separate everybody. They're wrapped up in his corner. There's the bell. Bronco Lovich trying to pull Kevin off Khan. Khan does not have the Oriental Spike now on Kevin, and there goes Bronco Lovich down, and Kevin is going to try to hold it on. Bronco Lovich trying to get after Kevin Von Erich, and Kevin is after Khan again. The bell is rung, but this is revenge. Here's some help now as these two go wild men. Rock and Roll Zumhoff comes up first. John Mantell trying to separate these two men who are at it to total destruction.
Of course, you recall when Chick Donovan battled the Killer Khan and came out of that ring with a severely injured knee. This was the action.
And now on the injured left knee of Chick Donovan. Judo chopping that knee. Donovan suffered a leg injury a while back. And Killer Khan is finding all sorts of pleasures in this one. Killer Khan taking total charge now with handsome Chick Donovan. On the bottom rope, and Killer Khan gonna drop down on that left leg. This could be a real loser for Donovan. Oh, goodness. After in that knee again, Donovan taking terrible punishment. Terrible punishment, and he has said, let's stop this thing. Khan just obliterating Chick Donovan, and Donovan finally couldn't stand the pain any longer. And Khan is still trying to injure. Trying to injure with intent now. And here comes Kevin. They wanted Kevin. Here comes Kevin. And Khan comes to meet him. Now Kevin may have a little trouble getting in. Now he's in the ring. And here comes that war that raged the last time. And away they go. Kevin and Khan in an unofficial battle. Kevin really rapping. And Khan is just as tough and mean and serious.
And we'll visit Chick Donovan at his hospital bed next on World Class Championship Wrestling. We're visiting Chick Donovan here in the Veterans Hospital after Chick has undergone surgery on his left knee. You saw the confrontation with Killer Khan, the point that he injured that knee, and you saw the battle with Kevin Von Erich and Killer Khan. Kevin and I are here today. Chick, good to see you, and sorry to see you in the hospital, but you're looking well. What did the doctor do to your knee?
I just like to say I thank all the people for dropping in today and just being with me, because I miss being out there with you. But the doctor just did extensive repair to the knee, and he put a screw through the left side and bolted it down to the right side, which would be in for the rest of my life. And it's just pretty painful right now, but I think it's getting a little bit better.
What's the prognosis on your return to the ring?
Well, he said 6 months to a year, but you know, Bill, we're champions, we're professional athletes, and sometimes we have more determination than the normal individual. So I'm working it real hard. I'm going to work extremely hard because I've got a goal of mine to get back. So I'll be there. It's hard to say how long, but I'll be there as soon as I can.
Kevin, it would appear that Killer Khan is not just interested in winning bouts, but interested in hurting people deliberately.
Bill, that's hitting the nail right on the head. He deliberately put that spike to me until blood came out of my mouth. Chick Donovan here, we all saw what happened. It was deliberately, deliberately tried to hurt Chick. Here Chick is laying in bed now. He's got a wife, family to support. Something's got to be done. And I guarantee you something is being done. The people think when I go to the ring, I'm a madman. I'm going crazy. Well, there's good reason for it. It's not just this. The guy thinks he can run roughshod over everything in this area. No way. Not against me, and not against Chick Donovan, not against any Von Erich. Next time I get a chance with Killer Khan, Chick, I guarantee you I'm going to give it all I got.
Okay, but now, Bill, like I said, he tried to put Kevin out of wrestling. He injured me to the point where I'm laid in the hospital for no telling how long right now. Something's got to be done to Killer Khan. He kind of reminds me of the old redwood tree that stands strong and tall, but if you chip away long enough and hard enough at the base of that tree, it's going to fall. And I know Kevin has got enough determination because he is a champion. He has enough determination about him to chop that tree right down and take care of that Khan.
Chick, I guarantee you I will do it.
What what can you do, really, to get this guy? What is the sort of the process? He's huge. He's tough.
Like Chip said, he's you can chip away at him and chip away, but I look at it another way. When the minute that bell rings, I'm coming with full head stern. I mean, I'm going at him with all I got, just like I've been doing. They're talking about pulling my license away and not letting me wrestle anymore. They're going to have to do that because that's the only thing that's going to keep me off Killer Khan. I guarantee you, I'm going to get rid of him.
Well, thank you, Bill. I appreciate all you fans. And thank you, Kevin, very much for coming out.
Better,
and,
good to see you,
thank
Chick.
You, Bill.
You take care of yourself. Kevin Von Erich and I visiting Chick Donovan here in the Veterans Hospital as Chick recovers from knee surgery after that deliberate attack by Killer Khan. And we'll be back with more World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment. Kaniski. As we have World Class Championship Wrestling with Rock and Roll and Kelly Kaniski. Kelly and Zumhoff open it up, and Buck Rock and Roll Zumhoff getting that headlock on Kelly Kaniski. First bout on World Class Championship Wrestling. As we showed you the effects of Killer Khan on Kevin Von Erich, I mean, particularly on Chick Donovan. Chick Donovan put out of action for some time now. We don't know exactly how long. With me here on our first bout on World Class Championship Wrestling is Gary Holder. You just met Gary ringside as Kelly Kaniski and Zumhoff battle it out here. Well, Gary, you mentioned this book that you've written, Requiem to a Champion, is about David Von Erich. It's also about the entire Von Erich family. And
yes, sir, it sure is. We start off, in fact, in David's background with a little bit of news about Kevin and the family. You know, Doris has always been kind of the family figure in the background, and she's mentioned in there. But it gives the fans a real inside look at the Von Erich family.
And how do they get a copy?
All they have to do, Bill, is write me. And by the way, I would suggest that they send a postcard. That'll save me opening up a lot of letters.
That's a good idea.
Write me, and my name is Gary Holder, H-O-L-D-E-R. Post Office Box 2306, Dallas, Texas, 75221.
I think we've had a visual on this a little earlier, but that's good. We'll repeat that as we a little later on.
Right, right.
Ah, but we will look at the address later, so you'll have an opportunity to write that down.
Okay.
Zumhoff with a headlock on Kaniski, son of Gene Kaniski, famed wrestler who, Gary, at years back, Gene Kaniski and Fritz Von Erich had some pretty terrible encounters.
Oh. It is so interesting to go back in time, Bill, and just to hear some of the stories these men have to tell. They are really war stories.
Oh, that is true. Great move by Zumhoff. And Kaniski having all sorts of trouble with the Rock and Roll Man. David Manning goes to the count of two. Well, Zumhoff, who has teamed up with Iceman King Parsons and teamed up very successfully. Successfully to the point where they have unshrouded, if that's the proper term, the Super D's. At least they've unmasked them. Super D's, Wild Bill Irwin and his brother Scott Hall Irwin. And now that you find out it's one of the Irwins, you see why the nickname fits so well. It's Kaniski back around now with that head scissors on Zumhoff. And this Kelly Kadiski, following in his father's footsteps.
Ooh, referee almost got it.
That was a tough one. Well, Zumhoff takes it over now, working on a good leg flip. And the rock and roll man is warmed up. Well, it doesn't take too much to get warm in this summertime. By the way, World-Class Championship Wrestling is going to be in New Orleans shortly. And featured will be the stars of the Von Erichs and many other World-Class Championship Wrestling stars. New Orleans in the near future. Well, that's good news. That's right around World's Fair now. That makes a great trip.
Certainly be a crowd. You know, we have a fan club for the Von Erichs, and we get mail literally, Bill, from all over the world. We had a letter just the other day from Israel.
I can believe that. Well,
from Israel. We get letters from Canada. Von Erich fans all over the world.
Well, World-Class Championship Wrestling, the videotape pretty well circles the globe now. And I'm sure that the Von Erich young men have a tremendous following wherever that tape is shown.
Well, that's the wonderful thing about the Von Erichs, that they project such a wholesome image.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of people are surprised to find out that they'd even have a chaplain for wrestlers. But what they forget is that these are men.
That's
right. And it's good to have heroes that stand for something, that stand for what's right and what's good.
That was a suplex you just saw, and Zumhoff, that's out of that count of two. Well, you have really chaplained a lot of athletes, haven't you?
I've had an opportunity, Bill, to work with many people in the NFL and the NBA, in Major League Baseball, National League, and American League, teams such as the Rangers and the Atlanta Braves, the Los Angeles Lakers. It's an exciting time. You get a lot of free tickets, too.
Well, your message is free, and that is the important thing, too.
That's exactly
your message
right.
Is free and wholesome. There's a count of two, and Zumhoff just rolling Kadiski out of there in time. Kelly Kadiski with an abdominal stretch on Zumhoff. And that may put the rock and roll man out of tune. Zumhoff in dire straits right now as Kelly Kadiski tries to stretch him out. And Zumhoff with his tremendous strength is pulling him right back. Nice move. Kind of a fireman's lift. He got Kadiski off his back. But got Kadiski into his back right there. Kadiski hammering on Zumhoff. World-class championship wrestling. 5 minutes gone. And these men working up a perspiration here as they come in. Zumhoff goes down. Flying body slam, two and not three. Mentioning your book, Gary, you have some, now we watch Zumhoff fight back, but these guys really been hammering away. And rock and roll has hit the floor. I was going to say, Fritz Von Erich has some audio messages that are available too, I understand.
What we've done, Bill, we have made it possible for the fans to have this book, first of all, free. Doesn't cost anyone a single cent. All they have to do is write. But then we've also gone ahead and produced a tape that goes into great detail about Fritz's life, and especially how he began in wrestling, why he happened to come back to Texas, how he established this empire, this dynasty of wrestling power here in Dallas. And it's just a tremendous look at the man, Fritz Von Erich. And we have that tape available, and it's mentioned in the book, and they have an opportunity then to They have an opportunity then to get the book, and then there's an order blank in the back of the book that all they have to do is write me again, and the tape is available. We got the charge for that tape.
Yeah,
We estimate to send out thousands and thousands of dollars worth of these books. We have some men that have graciously agreed to help me pay for it. But then the tape, we're going to have to get a little something back on that. But we explain all that in the book. And
all right,
I don't believe the fans will have a problem with it.
Very good. Jim Hawk, ready to rock and roll now. Got the roaring back. And this game, wrapped and wrapped again. Jim Hawk. Let's go to Mark Lorenz for the time.
In exactly 10 minutes, Nevada has declared a time limit draw with no winner.
No winner, time limit draw, and Killer or Kelly Kuniski and Buck Zumoff, that one up, a world class championship record. And we'll be back. Team Carson. At World Class Championship Wrestling's main event next week, Kevin Von Erich and gentleman Chris Adams team up against this awesome duo, Terry Gordy and Killer Khan. The main event next week on World Class Championship Wrestling. And there is the Texas and American Heavyweight Champion, Gino Hernandez. Gino, as he calls himself the handsome half-breed, certainly a gift to the ladies. And at times, a rather distracting individual. He's proud of the championships. Rather
this next bout, ladies and gentlemen, one fall, 20 minute time limit. Outside on the apron, holding his American heavyweight title belt, is the man who also holds the current Texas heavyweight championship. He's from Highland Park, 240 pounds, the handsome half-breed, Gino Hernandez. And behind me, his opponent from St. Louis, the gateway city to the west, 235 pounds, Iceman King Parson. David Manning, your referee.
Well, indeed, a young man from Highland Park. In fact, he has graciously invited us to meet at his penthouse pool. Well, we may be able to do a little interview with him. Gino Hernandez, the Texas and American Heavyweight Champion. And he's going against Iceman King Parsons, whom he's insulted on just about every occasion, including right now. Iceman King Parsons, who, as we mentioned a moment ago, has teamed up with Buck Rock and Roll Zumhoff and unmasked the Super D's. And then Super D Wild Bill Irwin, literally with his bull whip, Iceman King Parson. So we should find a chance, and I'm sure that Iceman is looking for it, to get some revenge against Wild Bill Irwin. Right now, Gino Hernandez holding two championships, the Texas and American. Both under a certain amount of controversy. And the Von Erichs are particularly upset that Gino has the Texas championship. Oh, nice leg takedown by Gino Hernandez. Good roll out of there by Iceman King Parsons. As these two outstanding young athletes maneuver in the early moments of this World Class Championship Wrestling match. David Manning, the referee, as Gino Hernandez is caught in a hammerlock by Iceman King Parsons. Have been doing some investigating on the rampant rumor that the general, the man, Skander Akbar, is making a deal making a deal with a wrestler as a partner for the missing link. And the word is that I get in hushed circles that it will shock the wrestling world. Well, we shall see. I hope soon who that is. They will still try to find out through some sources if we can reveal, find out and reveal who Akbar has in mind. Of course, Akbar shocked us before when he brought in Kabuki. A surprise it will be, I'm sure, if the man who can spend all the money he wants to, Gino Hernandez told a break by David Manning because he came off the rope. And now the argument goes on. A discussion of the validity of the ruling by David Manning, whether or not Gino Hernandez. Oh, pulling the trunks. Headbutt by Iceman King Parsons for a little bit of that truck pulling episode. Right back in. Iceman takes a few shots. Gino Hernandez popping in. Gino trying to come up with a one-leg stand now on Iceman King Parsons. I mentioned that we might be able to visit Gino Hernandez, hopefully very shortly. Ah, there's a knee jam on Hernandez's knee, but it puts Iceman in a bad predicament. Hate to see those knees take that punishment. There's a sort of a half scissor. After looking at Chick Donovan's heavily wrapped and braced knee. Well, a little pickup of a slogan, Go Ice Go here. Gino Hernandez, as I said he might invite us to his penthouse pool if we promise not to track anything across his 3-inch carpet. I'm sure we can probably dutifully and totally clean our shoes before visiting such an elite place. Well, the double champion right now has Iceman in little trouble, and Iceman feeling the effects of that pressure on his knee, but now it's Iceman whacking that leg across the head of Gino Hernandez. Gino, very cautious now against Iceman. He is known to flaunt Iceman, but he also has respect for him. And the Iceman giving a little move there. That's disconcerting. Good takedown by Gino. But Iceman maneuvers around like a dancing squirrel. Comes off his shoulders. Now the one-legged stand, but I think Iceman has the advantage and does, and rolls up Gino. One. Not two, good move by Gino getting out of that. Hey, speaking of sinister things, those bad street matches of six-man world-class tag championships, the Von Erichs and the Freebirds, and that roaring feud continues, skyrockets into the universe as once again the belt is held up. In the last match, that same NWA official whom you had an opportunity to meet recently, who made the ruling to hold the belt up in the first place, was on hand. And once again, due to the violence and the manner in which the bout was concluded, has once again held up the six-man world-class tag team championship. That does not hold up the bitterness and the irreconcilable hatred that goes on between the Von Erichs and the Freebirds. Scissoring those legs reverse-wise now is Gino Hernandez. There's a handsome man. Have to give a man a credit.
Coming up is Iceman and going right back down as great pressure is exerted by Kino Hernandez. We were very happy to have Gary Holder with us, visiting with us in the first bout, and we will be showing you the address later on World Class Championship Wrestling where you can send for your free copy of Requiem to a Champion. And you're all welcome. Welcome to have a copy. Gino Hernandez. He hangs on and hangs on there, but now he kind of let his guard down. The nice man is wrapping a solid arm around his jaw. Strong, sinewy, shiny bodies battling on World Class Championship Wrestling. And once again, Iceman is trying to protect that knee, but Gino Hernandez goes right back to it. What was so startling, there's a drop, that dangerous drop. What was so startling in the casualty report we had on Killer Khan was the fact that while Khan was continuing to attack Kick Donovan, he was actually and at that moment doing severe internal damage to the knee. And Chick was in just abysmal pain. What a wham across the chest of Gino Hernandez. Another great shot by Iceman King Parson. Another tremendous blow. And the Iceman cometh with his attack. And there goes Gino flying high. Gino staggered by Iceman. David Manning trying to extricate himself and does. And Iceman King Parsons wants no handouts, no handshakes, no expression of sympathy or friendship. And now close to the end of this bout. Iceman. Oh, what a toss. What a strong, strong physique. Count of two, but Gino kicks out of there nicely. Gino making a fine move too to put Iceman through the ropes. Shakes him up for a second to get the shot in there. There goes Iceman in the corner, but he shakes it off. Kicks it off again, comes roaring back on Gino Hernandez, the double champion. And Gino flies. Iceman King Parsons in command again. Has overcome the problem with the knee. Does a double scrub on the side of the head. And Gino is in trouble again. One more. And Gino very smartly dropping out of the grasp. Nice butt. Gino came out of a lot of trouble then to turn that around into his own attack. And he does. Oh, Iceman meets him. Wham! Tremendous knee lift. Oh, what a fierce contest between two sculptured athletes. Look out, Gino, you just about got the referee. Gino just hanging there, just hanging. A nice, clever shot like a bolo right there. Boom, and there goes Gino. One, two, and the leg goes up. Gino Hernandez taking everything now that Iceman can fire on him. Another shot. And again, Gino battles out. Well, sometimes he's dastardly, sometimes he's irrepressible and a boor, but most of the time he is an outstanding wrestler. And that was a great move by Iceman King Parsons. Gino comes over the top. Parsons had a chance to win it all then and couldn't hold it. There goes Iceman again. Up and over, gonna roll him up. No, Gino turns it around, rolls him back. One, two, and three, and Gino. Gino takes Iceman King Parsons. Gino getting the victory. Iceman is protesting, and I thought he might have had a tight in his right hand. We couldn't see it from this angle. We'll see as we look at a replay, and maybe it'll show us. There goes Gino up. And Gino extricates himself, pulls up. Yep, he's got a handful of truck on the right side. There it is. The evidence is in. We don't even need a court order for that. And let's go to Mark Lorenz.
In 13 minutes and 9 seconds, Gino Hernandez wins the event.
The American and Texas Heavyweight Champion Gino Hernandez, and we shall be back with the main event on World Class Championship Wrestling.
You bunch of stinking cowards!
One fall main event, 45-minute time limit. Devastation Incorporated's General Akbar presents, outside the ring on the apron, 245 pounds, the diabolical missing link. And across the ring, his opponent, from Denton County, the modern-day warrior and former world heavyweight champion, Kerry Von Erich. Bronco Lubitsch, your referee.
Diabolical is one of the fine adjectives that we could describe the missing link. We should try to arrange to discuss. We got to get a little start a little early as the link goes after Kerry Von Erich. We got to say to discuss the true missing link and how the physical link here is a part of that biological mistake. As Kerry Von Erich goes to the attack on the link, and the link straightens out everything with his own attack on the corner buckles, and Kerry Von Erich working the weird man from everywhere and nowhere. And if the link likes it, undoubtedly everybody else must like to have their head smashed into that corner buckle. And the link trying to decapitate or incapacitate Kerry Von Erich, missing. A carry with a tremendous flying drop kick. And look at the young man. Oop. The link now up to the chair, not to attack the other man, but to kind of scramble his own advisory system into action. Let's see if he's going to be in that chair in the ring. Up. And he just about got the Wizard of Oz cameraman down there. Unskillfully dropping chairs about. Akbar is telling Link he has to get back or he's going to be counted out. Undoubtedly, the Link can't understand Akbar. And I mentioned earlier that Akbar has the whole wrestling world in a tizzy, if you please. As Kerry Von Erich goes right back to his duties of trying to beat. Nice move by Link. Flying headbutt at grasping the post lock and crashing into the forehead of Kerry Von Erich and setting it up again. There's another shot with that head. I think maybe the missing gene or link or whatever it is probably a Roman battering ram that somewhere down the line figured in the family tree of this man. Look at this thing. There's a count of two, and Akbar pulling out Kerry Von Erich, and we'll see if he's going to be, yes,
Akbar will be disqualified, and so will Malik, as Akbar interfered. And Kerry Von Erich going to work on Akbar. And the link. And trying to get both of them, but he misses Akbar, so just good measure link. And Kerry Von Erich straightens out things as Akbar is disqualified by pulling Kerry Von Erich from the side of the apron. And now the link has second thoughts. Watch that. That corner post, you see the battering ram technique, because the link always seems to have an affinity for steel corner posts. And Akbar, there's the winner. Your hero, the world's hero, and the gift from Lake Dallas, Texas, Kerry Von Erich. Oh, what a shot. Oh, what a shot, Kerry Von Erich. Bratting the link. And if he was a little dizzy before he got in the ring, he's certainly dizzy now. Watch out in front. Yes, that may be the hardest head in the world. May very well be the hardest head in the world. And Kerry is inviting him back in for another session. Look out, Link. That's not a relative. There, that strange apparition is. DNA, missing links, genes, whatever. In future, we promise you to find out in what manner this man may fit into the world's design. Oh, let's look at the re-chair of the play break again, the chair break. Yes, the link does enjoy battering that head into most anything. And let's go to Mark Lorenz.
3 minutes, 25 seconds. Kerry Von Erich will be declared the winner after the interference by Akbar.
Kerry Von Erich, the winner, and we'll be back to tell you more about world-class championship wrestling. Let me give you the address of the book, The Requiem to a Champion, David Von Erich. That's box 2306, Dallas, Texas, and the zip code is 75221. Again, that's Gary Holder, H-O-L-D-E-R, box 2306, Dallas, Texas, 75221. Requiem to a Champion, David Von Erich. Now, next week on World Class Championship Wrestling, we've got a sizzler for the main event. The summertime is a sizzler, but this is even a bigger sizzler. This one features Kevin Von Erich and Gentleman Chris Adams against the diabolical pair, Terry Gordy of the Freebirds and Killer Khan. Next week, we'll see you then. So long.